Let's check on European markets. They are mixed in afternoon trade as investors gear up for a busy week of earnings and a trio of interest rate decisions. In the region in particular, the Bank of England will be coming out with its decision on Thursday. Looking at the London FTSE 100, it is up nearly 0.8%. As for Wall Street, futures are pointing to a positive open, with contracts tied to the tech-heavy NASDAQ up 0.7%. It will be a big week for the index, with four of the magnificent seven mega-cap tech stocks set to report. The Fed is also coming out with its interest rate decision on Wednesday.
Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Dutch brewer Heineken, which reported weak half-year results. The news sent Heineken stocks down nearly 8%. Also in focus, shares of Abbott and Reckitt Benckiser. That's after a U.S. jury found that Abbott's baby formula causes an increased risk of bowel disease. Abbott shares plunged 6% in pre-market trading. Reckitt shares also tanked 10% as investors fear a similar outcome for the British company's own litigation. We're also keeping a close watch on Philips after the company reported a positive second quarter with growth in sales, margins, and order intake. Philips shares jumped 10%.
Here in Asia, markets ended Monday trade higher as investors picked up gains ahead of key events this week. The Nikkei 225 jumped over 2%, snapping an eight-day losing streak before the Bank of Japan's interest rate decision on Wednesday. The Hong Kong Hang Seng and the South Korean KOSPI, meanwhile, climbed 1.2% each. Here at home, the local bourse sat out the rally, falling to profit-taking.
Market is not just ready just yet to break out the 6,800 level.
Yeah.
Basically, we just had a super typhoon last week. Mm-hmm. People are still on the sideline, observing how the market will react. Of course, some people are still scared to buy on breakout in anticipation of what we are hearing regarding the rate cuts.
Some notable stock movements in the region. Shares of Japan's Eisai plunged 13%, its biggest one-day fall in 3 years. That's after the European Union's regulator rejected a drug maker's medication for early Alzheimer's. Shares of Japan's Mitsubishi, on the other hand, jumped 2% on reports that it will join the alliance between Honda and Nissan to standardize in-vehicle software that controls the car. And finally, Alibaba shares surged 4.7% after Bloomberg reported the e-commerce giant plans to hike service fees for merchants.
The local earnings season slowly kicking into high gear. Banco de Oro nets $39.4 billion in the first half of the year. The C's banking arm attributes this to stronger momentum from its core intermediation and fee-based service business. BDO's net interest income also up 11% to $99.6 billion due to an increase in consumer loans across all market segments. Meanwhile, Union Bank posts a 20% drop in its first half profit to 5.1 billion pesos. This despite the Aboitiz-led bank delivering a strong top line at 37.3 billion, driven by the bank's expanding consumer business, higher net interest margin, and growing transaction fees. Its net interest income also grew 15%. As for Philippine National Bank, its consolidated net income in the first half grew 6% thanks to strong interest income from its loan portfolio and treasury assets. The Lucio-Tan-led bank also tempered the impact of higher interest expenses on deposits by deploying these to assets with better yields. And finally, Meralco posts a 21% increase in its first half bottom line to 23.2 billion pesos. The power distributor cites higher sales volumes and increased sales in the second quarter due to the higher availability of power generation plants. Total energy sales volumes also reached a record high of 33,000 gigawatts per hour on the back of growth profits from its residential and commercial segments.